Hello guys, peace of the Lord with everyone. I was like, always a question like what I need to do to go to heaven if I am a Muslim. And the Muslim says to you, Islam teach you to behave, Islam teach you how to be a good person, Islam teach you, Islam teach you. I do not get it. Their prophet, this is Sahih Bukhari, and again, this is the official government website of Saudi Arabia. As you see, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, official government website. It's not our website. This is not a Christian website. You can reserve to do Hajj. As you see, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Islamic, Ministry of Islamic Affairs. This is very, very, very extremely Islamic website. So now this is Sahih al-Bukhari. And in Sahih al-Bukhari is telling us who is really going to go to heaven. Do I need to go to be a good guy in Islam to go to heaven? Absolutely no. All what you need to do, you say Shahada. And from where I get that, there is many proofs. I will give you some of them. This is Sahih al-Bukhari, the book of Bid al-Khalq, the start of creation, the chapter name, Dhikru al-Malaika, mentioning the angels. Hadith number 2983, and as you see, this is hadithislam.com. The Prophet, he's saying, the Prophet of Islam, he's not my prophet for sure, قال لي جبريل, Gabriel, he told me, من مات من أمتك, the one who did die from your nation, and he do not worship any god but Allah, he will enter the heaven. دخل الجنة. And he will never enter the hell or the fire. The Prophet, he said, even if he committed adultery and he steal, he said, even. Even if you commit adultery and you steal, he said, even. So in Islam, simply clear. You are going to heaven, you do adultery, you do steal, you are a bad guy, you do drugs, you do whatever you want to do. Go and do everything. And this is explained to us, the Muslim behave. Muslims, they go and do all kind of dirty stuff all their life, and they go to Hajj, they walk around the Kaaba few times, and then they are clean. They kiss the black stone. If you ask Muslims why the black stone is black, they will say it used to be white, but when you kiss it, the black stone is sucking your sin. Sucking your sin. So when you go to do Hajj, you will be clean again. But in any way, you're clean or you are not, you are going to go to heaven. And this is what the Prophet of Islam is saying by himself. And in here you will see there is no need to repent. There is no need for anything. Because the promise is very clear. Anyone from your nation who did die, and he believe in Allah, he is going to go to heaven, no hell, absolutely no hell. The Prophet, he said to him, even if he did adultery, even if he commit zina, he said yes. Even if he steal, he said yes. So what is left? This is why we see Muslims are allowed to steal, especially from Christians, from Jewish. It's okay for them because this is not haram. And even harming Muslims is not haram. Because you know what? Anyway, I'm going to go to heaven. Anyway, I'm going to read the hadith. It's very clear. And this is a contradiction for what Muhammad he say in different places, because Muhammad, he, you will see in those hadith, he is just Muhammad trying to seduce people to believe in him. He's talking to a bunch of Bedouin, all of them, they are adulterers, they are thieves, they are killers, they are criminals. So he's saying to them, just believe in Allah and you will go to heaven. What you will lose, just do it. And if you want to read the explanation of the hadith, by the way, it's in the front of you, in the same page. Thank you. Now this is another hadith from Sahih al-Bukhari, the same story, hadith number 5379, because always I know Muslims, they will say, oh, this is the only hadith, there is, I can give you tons of them. So Sahih al-Bukhari, the book of al-libas, the chapter name, the white clothes. The book name is the clothes or the clothing. Hadith number 5379. The Prophet of Islam said that everyone, he will enter the heaven if he believe in Allah. Anyone from his nation, even if he commit adultery, and even if he is a thief. And he said this is what happened, you know, if Abu Darda like it or not. Abu Darda means Satan. So the Satan, you know, the Satan, when we say the Satan is making us doing sin, so what he's trying to do? What he's trying to do? If we will go to heaven anyway, after we do sin, so what the idea? This is will show the idea, you know, how stupid is the whole idea of Islam. You know, just believe in Allah and you are going to go to heaven. So you can be, you know, you can be a dirty man, you can do whatever you want to do, but you are going to go to heaven. What are you worried about? And this is explaining the behavior of Muslims all over the Middle East, all over in Pakistan, you know, drugs, adultery, thefts, all kind of disgusting stuff you can see ever, and you can dream. And by the way, always they accuse the West for being adultery people and being dirty and being pigs. But the Muslims cannot keep one street clean in the Middle East. Not even one street. And adultery is legal in Islam. We will talk about it. We will show you a verse in the Quran saying that adultery is legal. Prostitution, exactly. Prostitution. But this is a different topic. Let us finish this one. This is the same hadith from what? From the book of Sahih Muslim. The book of Sahih Muslim. So, this is hadith number 138. Sahih Muslim, the book of Al-Iman, the faith. The chapter name, who did die and he don't worship any god but Allah, he will enter the heaven. This is even the chapter name. And you will see the same story saying that وَإِنْ زَنَا وَإِنْ سَرَقْ وَإِنْ زَنَا وَإِنْ سَرَقْ. Even if he commit adultery, even if he's a thief, even if he commit adultery, even if he's a thief, he will enter the heaven. Guaranteed, don't worry about it. And you will see in here, that's no need to repent. And this is a danger about this. Like, you know what? If he's saying, okay, if you repent, you will enter the heaven. No, he's saying it clearly, if you believe in Allah, you don't commit shirk, that's it, you are in heaven. He didn't say any one of the Muslims who did not commit shirk and he did sin, but he repent for God, he will be forgiven and enter heaven. No, he said anyone who do not commit shirk with Allah, he is going to enter the heaven, guaranteed, even if he commit adultery, even if he do sin. And this is showing us how filthy this teaching, because it's just to seduce people to join, especially people who they are filthy and bad. Join in, get in, don't worry. Even if you are dirty, so what? I will let you go inside the heaven. Just believe in me. So this is what Muhammad trying to do, trying to make everybody believe in him. Anyway, we will continue later talking about how the Prophet of Islam used to order Muslims to rent women for sex. The Muslims now, they call it temporary marriage. You know, there is no marriage by renting women. As long as you are paying money for one night stand, how you call it marriage? They say, and even the name of that marriage, they call it muta, which means sexual joy. This is what the name. So how you call it marriage? The marriage is something you do to establish a family. This, what your prophet himself practice, it is about how to have a woman for one night or two nights or three nights, and you pay her, and before even you sleep with her, you make an agreement with her for how many days you want to sleep with me and how much money you will take as payment. You see, and this is the Prophet of God, allowed in his men, and he himself practicing that, to rent women in the bed for sexual need only, not for family, not to marry. So they call it marriage, but it's absolutely not a marriage. This is what Muhammad did. He gave different names for adulteries. It's adultery, he called it marriage. But, and here, before we finish this one, as you see, even if you commit adultery, even if you are a thief, you do not need to repent in Islam. You will enter to heaven. Just believe in Muhammad. Just believe in Allah. And you are inside the heaven of Allah. Where you are going to have what? You will have 72 women for sex. Because the whole idea of Islam is sex. You pray, you fast, you die, you kill, you hate for Allah. And then what you will get? Sex. This is why I believe strongly that Allah is a sex God. Thank you.